Hey guys, today I'm gonna be showing you how I sanded, painted. I'm showing you guys the whole process of how I made this 3D printed Batman cowl. So the helmet was fully printed and I glued all the pieces that need to be glued together, and I also put in magnets for the jaw piece. As you can see, this is a model from DO3D.com, the Batfleck concept art, I believe it's called. So you can see it holds in just like that, and then there's magnets attached to the jaw right there and on the inside. So right now that it's all glued together, you can see the seam right here. That was all a different piece, and I glued it all together. So now what I'm doing is you can see a lot of the layer lines, and if you could see all those small little lines, and those will show up when I inevitably paint it. So what I'm doing right now is I'm taking something called, I usually use Bondo. This is a different brand that I'm just trying out. It's called Bondo Glazing and Spot Putty. This one is by Evercoat. It works okay. They're all kind of the same. They're like 7 to 10 bucks or something like that. And all I'm doing is I'm taking a little bit of it and putting it on my finger, and then I'm rubbing it into the seams in the helmet. And what will happen is, once it's done drying, it's very easy to sand off. And if you're careful while sanding, you should be able to get a smooth kind of texture to the helmet. Obviously you can't just do Bondo, so I also use a Rust-Oleum 2-in-1 filler primer, which I'll show you guys how I use that later. But don't be afraid to be too generous on here. You can see I put a big amount on there, because the whole thing is, it's better to put more on than to put too little, because if you put too little, you're just gonna have to go back and do it again, which is an absolute pain. So you can see I'm just rubbing it in and making it basically so I don't see any white on it. It's so that it's all those layer lines are filled up.
Okay, so I just finished putting on all the Bondo for the jaw piece and the helmet. You can see it's all covered up. The only pieces that are still not covered up, and that I'm not going to cover up, is like the insides that are gonna be touching my skin. Cause those, it doesn't really matter how it looks like that. Because no one's gonna see it, cause it's gonna be on my head. So you can see all the little details and everything have been filled in. Now you can see there's still some small spaces, like right here and all across the helmet, where there still are some lines and from the layers, but a lot of those smaller ones are actually going to be filled up with the filler primer. Now you can also see, I also got the bottom, because that's a big thing that most people don't really think about. You got to do these bottom pieces right here, because those you can see very clearly that there was a lot of layers. It's a really easy spot to see where the layers are.
Okay, so the Bondo has fully dried. I don't know if you could tell, but it is slightly lighter now, a little bit lighter of an orange, and it is fully dry. It dries really quick. I would say maybe give it an hour, 45 minutes, something like that, to let it fully dry. Now, one thing when you're sanding is you really got to make sure you go from a really low grit. Like, I'm doing a 180, got like a piece of paper and a sanding sponge, and then move your way up. I'm going to go up to 1000 grit, because I really want this thing smooth for when I paint it. I really want it to look clean and nice. So, you can see, I just tested it out a little bit. You can see, all I'm gonna do is going in a circular motion. All I'm going to do is go in a circular motion around, and you're going to see some of that white from the plastic start to come back, and you want to go deep enough to where you can see almost all the white, and you're going to still see some a little bit of the Bondo kind of coloring, like you can see right there. You can see a little bit of the circles. You're going to see that, and that's just showing you where it is filled in and where there is too big of a gap. So I'll show you guys again. Just doing circular motions around the whole thing. Every once in a while, you're going to see it's going to get clogged up. I just like to bang it on my workbench and go back to sanding. Now, mine has two sides with this. I feel like that kind of helps to get into for the more kind of curved pieces, like the dome right here, or the kind of brow. I feel like that kind of helps. And I can already feel, just like rubbing my finger on it, it is already getting almost a million times smoother. Now, if you don't want to buy a sanding sponge, you could probably get just 180 grit sandpaper in like a package, probably a lot cheaper. If you don't want to buy a bunch of these sanding sponges, then what I like to do is I just like to take a piece of sandpaper, wrap it around it, and sand it like that. Now, I'm not gonna do that because this is a perfect grit, but as I start moving up in grit, I might start doing that. Okay, so I just finished doing all the sanding of the helmet and the jaw piece. You could slightly see the white from the original plastic coming through. You could see it's mainly a really light kind of orangish red. You could see there are some like darker spots where I didn't sand it as deeply, but those will be fine because they don't make as much of a difference. Now what we can do, now that it's all fully sanded and smoother, I sanded it at 180 grit, and now what we can do is we can take it and we can put it into the priming stage, which I'll show you guys now. Okay, for spraying, I use this 2-in-1 Rust-Oleum filler primer. You can find it all over the place, Home Depot, Lowe's, anything like that. And all I do is gotta make sure you shake it very well, and then just go about 8 inches away and do very even coats, doing spritz, let go, in strokes. Like this. You want to go until it's all gray. You can do this outside, I mean like a barn kind of area. The door open, so it's got plenty of ventilation. If you're inside in an enclosed space without a lot of airflow, then you're gonna want to be wearing a respirator. I try to get that bottom too. This bottom is an absolute pain. Okay, so I just finished letting the 2-in-1 filler primer dry. So now you can see a lot more of where it needs to be sanded now. It turned out pretty good, but you could still see the landlines. So I did a 180 grit before, so now I'm moving up to a 220 grit. And it's gonna be the same thing as before. Just going through it and sanding it down. And you wanna keep on repeating the priming and the sanding. After I'm done this and I prime it again, I'll probably move up to a 320 and then up to a 400 and then probably up to a 600 and then a 1000 grit. Okay. Now's around the time when you're going to have to start picking out paint colors. And one really good way to do it is to take spoons, like plastic spoons, and just spraying them. I was trying to decide between if I wanted to do a flat or a matte black for the helmet. So,
I took the spray paint and I just like the helmet, shake it up a little bit and spray it. Now I already did this a few hours ago, and this is how it turned out, and it's perfect for what I want. I also did it for some other things, like a Mandalorian helmet, trying out different kinds of silver, and I ended up getting this, which is like perfect for what I want. This is, if you know what color you wanna use, I still suggest doing this, because it works out so perfectly, and it really helps you see exactly what you're trying to do. You might think that a kind of paint is gonna work good, when in reality, it'll end up failing. I would also suggest trying out different layers. For my Mandalorian helmet, I ended up having to try doing glossy blacks and seeing how they matched up with each other to try it out. And I found out that doing a glossy black under a chrome worked out the best, which I would not have known unless I did the spoon method.
Okay, now that I'm done doing all the filler, I'm done with all the filler primer, because what happens is it ends up getting too thick. So you want to start using normal primer. This just happens to be the actual color that I'm using for my actual helmet, so it's also good to kind of test. So all I'm going to do, same thing as I did with the filler primer. Do quick strokes. All around the helmet. Try to keep it even. Don't put too much on. Once you start to see a lot of shine, that's when you want to move around and go to the other side. And then when you hopefully you come back to the other side, it dried at least a little bit for you to put more on. Because if you put more on while it's still wet, you're just gonna end up getting runs and you're gonna have to sand it down. And we don't want that. And this is all I'm doing for the jaw piece. Near the helmet, I'm just hanging it up on a little wire, and then all I do is I just go through, spray the sides that I can. The spotlight right there, I'll do after I do the first coat, and I just go and do the inside after. Same thing with this. After it's all done drying, fully dried, I flip it over and spray the inside, so no matter where you look at it, it's black. Okay guys, so you can see the helmet is fully completed. It's been a week since I finished this, and I think it turned out almost exactly how I wanted it to. It's got, the magnets are maybe, I would say, a little bit too weak. If I could go back, I probably would have bought a little bit stronger magnets. The finish on it is really clean. There's not a lot of layer lines. I mean, there's a few spots I wish I probably would have touched up, but to be honest, this is my first full helmet that I've fully completed, and I'm really proud of it. I wore it to my school a few days ago, and it was a hit. Everybody loved it, and I hope you guys can make your own and show it off to your friends and family. And this was my first video, so I hope you guys like it. My next video will be me showing you in a multitude of videos of me making a motorized Iron Man helmet that's Mark III with light up eyes and a motor that makes it so that the faceplate goes up. That'll be in a few different parts, including sizing, sanding and priming in one video, and then painting, color painting, and the electronics. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.